Good morning, everyone. Chief Meteorologist Matt Hollander wanted to give you an update on this winter storm. It's been a tricky forecast, but we're finally starting to get a clear picture of what exactly is going to happen. So let's not waste any time. Let's get right to your hour-by-hour forecast starting at noon today, because I think that's the earliest opportunity we have at seeing a few light rain showers. Now, it's quite possible that quite a bit of the region will be dry at noon, but I just want to mention that noon is the earliest we might start to see few little sprinkles starting to pop up. Now, as we go through the afternoon, I think you have a better and better shot of seeing rain. Check out 6 o'clock. We'll still call it scattered rain showers at this point, but you have a better opportunity of seeing rain at 6 o'clock than noon. Notice it is still all rain. So there could be a little bit of rain around for the homebound commute, but we're not talking about ice. We're not talking about snow. So just a little bit of rain to slow things down just a touch. We're going in 6 hour increments here. So now let's jump ahead to 12 a.m. on Thursday. Now we're seeing some shades of yellow showing up, indicating a little bit heavier rain, more widespread rain, but notice over northwest Indiana, it is still rain. But you can see off to the west, there's some freezing rain, there's some snow. But at midnight, I still think it's going to be rain for us. And pretty intense rain. Again, for February, again, you'll be hearing the rain hitting your roof. All right, now we jump ahead to 6 a.m. So sometime after 3 a.m., we may start to see the transition to a little bit of freezing rain and sleet. But notice that the rain may still hold on for Jasper and Newton County. That is a possibility across the southern part of Jasper and Newton County. It may still be rain 6 a.m. Thursday. Now, you might be thinking, hey, what's going on? Looks like things are drying out. Not quite. We're actually going to see another wave of low pressure come in, and boy, this storm will be far from over. This is when the real snow is going to start to pile up. Here we are at noon on Thursday, so probably late morning, the snow will start to pick up. And during the afternoon, it looks quite snowy. And we're not talking about just light to moderate snow. We're talking about heavy snow. It's really going to lower visibility. And it's going to be windy, so some blowing snow as well. It is going to be an absolute mess trying to drive around Thursday. If you don't have to be on the roads, please don't, because it is not going to be an easy go. There's 6 p.m. Thursday. Snow still coming down. Still a possibility for some heavy snow as well. Now, after 6 p.m. Thursday, we're really going to see the intensity back off. Now, this particular model says we're completely dry by midnight Friday. I'm not completely sold on that. I think there could still be a little bit of flurry activity, but I do think by Friday morning, it will be dry, and we're going to catch a break from the activity on Friday. So how much snow are we talking about? Well, that's been the big change. Yesterday, the models were hinting at a prolonged period of freezing rain and sleet. Now it looks like that period of freezing rain and sleet isn't going to be that long, but we are going to be seeing more snow. And now, again, this is just one of the models, one possibility, but it's the model that's kind of in the middle of all of them. So I kind of like it the best. And look how it is quite likely that a lot of us are going to be seeing 6, 7, 8 inches of snow. That is a real possibility. And again, a lot of this snow is going to be coming down late morning Thursday through Thursday afternoon. So it's going to pile up real quick. Some really intense snow coming down that's really going to lower visibility. And you can see Northwest Indiana seeing some of the higher totals compared to the northwest side of Chicago, where snow totals are going to be smaller. I do have to mention, though, that underneath that snow is going to be that little bit of freezing rain and sleet. Now, we're not talking about a lot, but enough to cause some icy spots on bridges, overpasses, secondary roads. Now, particularly in Jasper and Newton County, that's where I think there'll be a little bit more of the freezing rain. There, we could be talking about as much as perhaps 0.15 inches. It's not a crippling ice storm. I'm not talking about an ice storm that could cause power outages, but certainly one that could put a layer of ice on your windshield, layer of ice on plants, and yes, create those icy spots. Not as much freezing rain in Lake Porter and LaPorte County. I think we're looking at 0.05 inches. To 1/10 of an inch at most. Sleet, yeah, I think we're going to see a little bit of that too. I think there's going to be more in Jasper and Newton County, where that transition to snow is going to take a little bit longer. So I think we're looking at 1/4 inch to 3/4 inch of sleet. Yes, with those little ice pellets piling up, maybe as high as 3/4 inch, especially in southern Newton and southern Jasper County. Meanwhile, Lake Porter and LaPorte County, it's possible there might not be any sleet. We might just go from a little bit of freezing rain straight over to snow, but if we do see some sleet, I think at most we're talking about 1/4 inch of sleet. Now, as far as snowfall possibilities, I think there's going to be more snow across the northern part of the region and less snow across the southern part of the region. Farther south, we have smaller snow totals, but still significant. In Jasper County, we're still talking about 5 to perhaps as high as 8 inches. Newton County, a little bit more, 5.5 to 8.5 inches. And going to go with a range right now for Lake Porter and LaPorte County of 6 to 10 inches of snow. So certainly a significant winter storm. Now, most of the region is under a winter storm warning, except LaPorte County. You're still under a winter storm watch. That is likely to change. It's kind of a timing issue, but that will probably be transitioned over to a winter storm warning. Notice that for Chicago, it's a winter weather advisory because they're not going to be seeing as much snow. And the timing for this winter storm warning, it begins 3 a.m. Thursday, because that's the earliest we can start to see that freezing rain and sleet. And then it continues till 9 p.m. Thursday, because that's when the threat for heavy snow will be over. So focus on this time, 3 a.m. Thursday, 9 p.m. Thursday, which is pretty much during the day Thursday. If you don't have to be on the road because of that sleet and freezing rain that's going to be underneath all of that snow, Thursday is looking like an absolutely great day to stay inside. If you do have to venture out, please, please be careful. Give yourself a lot of extra time to reach your destination. You're going to want to go way below the speed limit and definitely increase your following distance.